Good day, my schoolers. Welcome to my school channel. My name is Alexandra. Right here, we'll be tackling jam past question for the subject literature in English year 2018. Don't go anywhere, stay with us, and we'll be right back. My school channel, right here we'll be tackling question 55 to 61. Now let's begin with question 55. The question is based on George Orwell's 1984. The novel draws a picture of dash option A, useless past, option B, a totalitarian future, option C, an unstable moment, option D, a peaceful atmosphere. The answer to this question is option B, a totalitarian future. Now first and foremost, let's look at the summary of this text. Now, we see in this text that the system of government is totalitarian in nature and it indoctrinates people. And then we see the protagonist, the impression of Winston Smith, is conscious of this environment he finds himself, is conscious of the dehumanizing society he finds himself, and he tries to gradually fight against it. But he is eventually captured, tortured, and eventually he gives in, okay? He loses touch of his humanity, he loses touch of himself, and he is psychologically manipulated, and he begins to think in the new language, that is, new speak. Okay, so this is the summary of the text. But then the question says, the novel draws a picture of what? Now, in this text, we see that this text is written in year 1949, okay? And in this text, we see that when Winston Smith is addressing the future, okay, the future readers, and his diary points out to the date April 18, 1984. So he's talking to the future, he's telling them that, okay, there's a possibility that a totalitarian system of government would rise up and it would be so unbearable for people that people will be manipulated, people will not be able to think for themselves, they will not own their thoughts. They would language will be limited and they will be monitored all through. So he is addressing the future, and do not forget that every literary text is appreciated or discussed as though it is present. So we will still regard that text as, okay, a totalitarian text addressing the future. Okay, so therefore option B is the correct answer to this question. Question 56. The question is based on George Orwell's 1984, The Power and Oppression of an Irresistible Evil Debased Winston's Dreams of Dash. Option A, Internal Security. Option B, Wealth and Capitalism. Option C, Freedom and Democracy. Option D, Sovereignty Forestalled Reconciliation. The answer to this question is option C, Freedom and Democracy. Now, in page 22 of this text, we see that Winston tries to write something in his diary, something that we can describe as his dreams or what he wishes or hopes to get. So he writes to the future or to the past, to a time when thought is free, to a time when truth exists. We can summarize this that this talks about freedom and democracy, and we see that continuously in the text. We see him trying to get freedom, trying to be free from the totalitarian system, trying to rebel. He was rebelling secretly and it got to a time he wanted to rebel openly. Okay, so option C, therefore, is the correct answer to this question. Do not forget to take practice questions with our simulated JAMB CBT past questions. All you need to do is you click on the link in the description below. It takes you to my school website. There you can download my school mobile app for your Android phones or my school software for your computers and laptops. Go ahead and download and start practicing this question. Now moving on to question 57. The question is based on George Orwell's 1984. The novel can be described as dash. Option A, optimistic. Option B, antagonistic. Option C, persuasive. Option D, pessimistic. The answer to this question is option D, pessimistic. What does pessimistic mean? Now I'm going to apply the definition of this to a person. When one is pessimistic, is thinking that something bad is more likely to happen, or emphasizing on the bad aspect of a situation. Now when you read this book, we see that the text keeps describing the system of government, the totalitarian system of government, how dehumanizing it is, how terrible it is, how horrifying it is for people. And we see Winston Smith continuously is always agitating and trying to change this. Okay, so we can see that we can ascribe this to pessimistic. Okay, option D, therefore, is the correct answer to this question. I believe you're enjoying this content. If so, do not forget to hit the like button, click on the subscribe button, and tap on the bell notification to get informed as soon as we release the next videos. Question 58. The question is based on George Orwell's 1984. Room 101 symbolizes a place of dash. Option A, rest. Option B, fall. Option C, humiliation. Option D, torture. The answer to this question is option D, torture. Now, in this text, we see that Winston is taken through different stages of imprisonment, and the last stage of imprisonment is called Room 101. Now, he's taken to this stage and is confronted with his worst fears. Okay, so in this text, we are made to understand that individual fears are different. Okay, whatever makes me scared might not make you scared, whatever makes you scared might not make me scared. Okay, so in this room, you are terrorized with your fears, okay? And in this case, this thing was afraid of rats, and so he was scared with rats. He was threatened to be eaten by rats, okay? So, and because of this, he eventually gives in. He eventually becomes dehumanized, and at the end of this text, we see that he begins to declare love for Big Brother. Okay, so before taking him to room 101, O'Brien told him that we just don't want you to obey the laws. Okay, he has been tortured severally, okay? But then they take him to room 101 with the hope that he would start to love Big Brother. Because O'Brien said, we just don't want you to obey the laws. We want you, you must obey Big Brother. And after room 101, we see that Winston starts to love Big Brother. So option D, therefore, is the correct answer to this question. Do you have several questions you would like to ask? You can ask your questions by using the link in the description below. Click on this link. It takes you to the My School website. There you can ask your questions, and solutions will be provided to you within a short period of time. Now let's continue with question 59. The question is based on J.P. Clark's Wife's Revolt. In the play, the central idea is that gender equity dash option A, both undesirable and unattainable. Option B, desirable and unattainable. Option C, attainable and desirable. Option D, obnoxious and desirable. Okay, the answer to this question is attainable and desirable. That is, gender equity in this text is desirable and it is attainable. Now, this text talks about the revolt orchestrated by women or the wives. Okay, some amount of money is given to the community, and the community shares it or splits it into three: the elders, the men, and the women. Okay, so the woman rose up saying that this is unfair to them. Wife splits the money into three, giving the elders one and the men another part, since men are equally elders. So it should be split into two, men and women instead. So this resulted into the revolt, and eventually the women won, and it was attainable. Okay, so this text is trying to tell us that, okay, there are peaceful ways you can protest or demand for something. It doesn't have to be in violence, with the use of violence. Okay, it could be done in a very mature way or organized way, and then this thing would be achieved. Okay, so option C, therefore, is the correct answer to this question. If you have better steps, explanation, or solution to any of this question, feel free to use the comment section below. Indicate the questions and the solutions you would like to share. Question 60. The question is based on J.P. Clark's Wife's Revolt. In their fight, the women settled at Iara in order to dash. Option A, cure cross peace. Option B, hurt their husbands. Option C, forestall reconciliation. Option D, seeks peace. Okay, the answer to this question is hurt their husbands. Now, in this text, in page 11, okay, in the midst of the disputes between Coco and Okoro, we see that Okoro demands for his dinner, and then Coco replies. She says, "And I go in full flight to get your dinner. And better make sure you eat against the hungry days ahead." Okay, she has the intention, she knows what she's going to do, or she knows what the women are planning, and so she's doing this to make to hurt him, to make him suffer. Okay, to make him realize that in a hard way, that what you're doing, what you men are doing to the women, is considered unfair. Okay, and also we see that on hearing that the women had settled in Iara, Okoro declares in page 30, he tells Idama that, "I didn't know the woman ate us this much." And Idama replies that, "In a fight, you use what hurts the other the most. You use what hurts the most." Okay, the husband will usually beat the wife, and the wife will insult the husband. Okay, so the women consider that, okay, realize that they have to hurt the men to get what they want, and they have to do it in an organized way or in a very mature way. Okay, so this was what they did, and they eventually won. So option B is the correct answer to this question. Question 61. The question is based on J.P. Clark's Wife's Revolt. Those who have full breasts have walked out, and that leaves you, me, and the old girl's return dash. Option A, front of the veranda of Okoro's house. Option B, the kitchen upstairs. Option C, Okoro's front yard downstage. Option D, the direction of the kitchen offstage. The answer to this question is option A. You can find this in page 25 of this text, okay? Okoro made this statement in, at the front of his house. So it's also called veranda. Okay, so option A is the correct answer to this question. However, this statement is used to address his child in a bit to console him because he presumes he wants breast milk, which was currently unavailable because the women had left town. So option A, therefore, is the correct answer to this question. We've come to the end of the segment, and I believe you enjoyed it. Do not forget to hit the like button, click on the subscribe button, and tap on the bell notification to get informed as soon as we release the next videos.